I didn't look.
I'm Denae, and my husband is Sean, and we have three children, Malia, Mariam, and Mason. Mariam is 5, and she's just so sweet and thoughtful, very perceptive, detail-oriented. She has that spunk, that stubbornness about her.
Who wants to go to Chunky Cheese?
Oh, okay, that's a great
one. Mariam and I, we both were born with sickle cell disease. The day that we found out that Mariam had sickle cell, you know, there was the initial devastation. Even though I feel I had a good life, you still don't want your kid to have to, you know, go through any type of pain. You don't want to have to watch that. All right, guys. Hey, kids. It's time to eat. Let's go. I was diagnosed with sickle cell actually at 6 months. I had my first crisis at that time, and it was swelling of the hands. That is a manifestation of a sickle cell crisis. What happens is normal blood cells are a short circular shape, and they just freely flow through your vessels. In sickle cell, those cells turn into like a sickle shape, and they get stuck. And when they get stuck, the blood cells, they clump up, and that's what causes the crisis.
Sickle cell disease, the red blood cells, they're stiffer and stickier, and so they get obstructed in the blood vessels. And that can cause organ damage and pain. And some of that damage accumulates over time. And so the older that you are and the less well you've been treated over time, the more ill, the more sick, the more complications you can have. In the United States and a lot of countries, especially in Europe, Canada, there's universal newborn screening for sickle cell disease. We're able to identify the people with the condition, with sickle cell disease, those young babies, before they have any problems, to try to prevent the first problems from happening.
Cincinnati Children's has been a major player in research advances in sickle cell disease. We have had NIH grants for over 2 decades studying novel treatments in sickle cell disease. We've developed gene therapy for sickle cell disease here.
And so with early treatment, most kids in the United States and our center do grow up and become adults.
She's doing so much better than I was at 5. By the time I was 5, I had been in the hospital several times. That was a lot of my childhood. Just I remember being in and out of the hospital. Luckily, Mariam has not had a pain crisis yet. So she's 5, and part of me is like, okay, when's it gonna happen? When's it gonna happen? She hasn't had one yet, and I'm just so grateful and so thankful. She's been doing wonderful. She's on a medication called hydroxyurea. And I truly believe that medication is the reason why she hasn't had a crisis yet.
Years ago, hydroxyurea was the first therapy that got approved for sickle cell disease. Hydroxyurea is a drug that was used as a chemotherapy agent, so it increases the fetal hemoglobin. Fetal hemoglobin is the type of globin a baby makes as a fetus, and it switches off about 6 months to a year after birth. Hydroxyurea reactivates the fetal hemoglobin gene, and the fetal hemoglobin prevents the sickle red blood cells from changing their shape and becoming sickle shape. And hence, she doesn't get the bad symptoms of sickle cell disease.
I'm a pediatric hematologist or a blood specialist, but I don't do it all by myself. I have a huge team, other doctors like me, but even more importantly, we have a wide breadth of people that are always available and that we can mobilize to come and help with any particular situation that might arise.
I just think that she is an angel. She brightens the room, she engages people, and she loves her brother Mason. Kind of almost forget she has sickle cell, you know? I mean, she's just so strong. She almost displays nothing but strength.
My hope and aspiration for Mariam is that she lives her life to the fullest, and Mariam is gonna be okay. And I know that, and I believe that wholeheartedly.
I hope the best thing that we've been able to give for her is a normal childhood. She hasn't had severe pain or complications of her sickle cell disease. She's gone to school, she's growing well, she's developing well. So it's the things that she's avoided that we've given her, in a sense, by helping her stay healthy all the time.
I don't believe that she would get better care anywhere else. From her doctors to everyone involved, that level of care isn't always common, but it's a commonality for us.
They made me feel better and get to go home.